Hi, this is Baron from Ragic. Today I'm going to show you how to create a basic subtable on your sheets. Subtables are extremely useful when you need to keep multiple items in a record, such as having different contact records under a customer. Here's a simple customer form that I created before that contains some fields for contact information. I would like to add some fields to record phone calls and meetings with this customer, and the best way for this would be to have these fields in a subtable. I'll need a contact summary, type of contact, and a date field that I can track when this contact was made. To create a subtable, the first thing to know is that you cannot start to create a sheet with a subtable field. We already bypassed this because I have regular fields on my sheet, which are these. And to actually add the subtable fields, the important part is after adding the first field, like the contact summary, the rest of the fields would need to be lined up horizontally with the field headers right next to each other. So you can see that the fields have two parts, which is the field header. The blue part is where you name the field, and the white part is where the field value will be when you have data in your form. And when you're entering data in your form, you'll always be able to click the white parts. For the subtable, we're going to disregard this white part right next to this field header and directly place the field header for the next field, which is type of contact, next to the contact summary. So I'm going to add some selection options for the type of contact, is like phone call or meeting. And next to that, I think I wanted date and time field so that I can record my point of contact. So this is my subtable, and you can see that the values shifted below the subtable, and there are only three rows beneath the headers in the design mode, but rest assured the subtable will expand as you enter more values. I've finished creating my subtable and will save and exit here. So here's how this works. Whenever I contact John Doe, I'll update his entry in the subtable with some information on what the conversation was so that I can keep track more easily. For example, talked about the contract in a phone call, let's say around January the 4th, 5 p.m. And then let's say we had a meeting, initial meeting, as a meeting on the 6th, let's say 1 p.m. And that's how you enter values into a subtable. So this will expand whenever you add new entries to this subtable, and the data saved in your subtable will also be searchable in the top search bar in your sheet. And if you need to get more functionality out of the subtable, you can create a new sheet from your subtable in the design mode with linking that will display all records for all your entries, which is explained in another video. And that's about it. Have fun with your subtables and let us know if you have any questions.